guest is our returning champion, John Goss, originally from San Francisco, California. Stand by to see John play for all the prizes, plus a cash jackpot, a total of $131,933. Tonight, on America's Biggest Bargain Sale, we're offering a Nissan 300ZX valued at $23,794 for $530. Cash and prizes worth over $100,000 for $750. Two of the incredible bargains on Sale of the Century. And now, here's the star of our show, Jim Perry.
Hello there. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Good evening. Welcome to Sale of the Century. Well, did you hear those figures that Jay was talking about? What can I tell you? A fine champion. Let's bring him back. John Goss. Hello, John. I wasn't sure if I would see you this evening, John. I thought you might have left us on the last show.
I thought I might have, too, but...
John, of course, now, right now you've got $655 in your bank account. With that $655, all you had to do was say yes, and you could have left us with every prize we've got on that stage, including a beautiful trip, a luxury automobile. That was a total of almost $60,000 in cash and prizes. You could have left. You decided to take a risk.
But I wouldn't have seen Summer Bartholomew again.
Well, you are going to see Summer Bartholomew, and should John win again tonight... With $95. He must win. He must get another $95. He would see Summer. He would see all those prizes.
Winter, plus, spring, and fall.
Plus, he would see a cash jackpot of $72,000. Hey, he's nice and relaxed as he goes for it all. Let's bring her out now and make John's evening, Summer Bartholomew.
Thank you.
Isn't that a nice thing for him to say?
Yes, it is. Thank you.
And if some of our friends weren't with us a few shows ago, he also said you were his all-time favorite Miss USA.
Yes,
right?
That was very sweet of him. Thank you.
Who do you have? Now, unfortunately, after he says nice things about you, you're going to bring out a couple of people who are going to try to stop him.
Yes, I am. And our first challenger has a science fiction addiction from Los Angeles, California. Help us welcome Naomi Clinton.
Hello, Naomi.
Our second challenger specializes in unique wedding services from Los Angeles, California. Here is Chip Elmblad.
Hi, Chip. And we'll see you a little later with some bargain center. Chip, you specialize in unique wedding services. What does that mean?
Well, Jim, I love to do weddings in unusual places, such as boats, backyards, and I've even done one in a ravine between two houses.
Well, what do you do weddings?
Oh, I perform them. I'm a minister.
Oh, okay. All right. Now we got... That's good. It's just good to get that straight. Nice to have you here, Chip.
Thank you.
I think I could tell from the voice. Nice, deep, ministerial voice. Naomi. Chip's got me talking about her. Naomi, a science fiction addiction. What does that mean?
I am terribly serious about my science fiction, including the fact I hold reservations for the first commercial flight to the moon.
Oh, yes?
Yes, I do, since 1969.
Well, if you hold reservations, may I sincerely hope it's not science fiction, Naomi. Nice to have you here as well. $20 starts all three players off. And now let's get serious, because it is serious. John has taken a big risk. He's trying to walk away with all of our prizes, plus a cash jackpot of $72,000. He's got to win. He's got to accumulate another $95. Good luck to all three of you. We start with this. What big box office star played the fast-living movie stuntman Hooper? John?
Burt Reynolds.
Burt Reynolds is right. $5 for the correct answer. When John beats Chip to the buzzer, goes to 25. Name the toy with which you might walk the dog. Go, John?
A yo-yo.
Or just make it go up and down. Yo-yo is exactly what it is. And John, quickly, with two in a row for $30. In mathematics, the opposite of multiplication. Chip?
Division.
Division it is. Chip beats everyone to the buzzer. He gets his first five at 25. According to the old rallying cry of the American Revolution, no taxation, John.
Without representation.
That's the word we wanted. Representation it is, and John at 35. Name the meat that comes from calves. No more than Chip.
Veal.
14 weeks old, you are right. Veal it is, and Chip keeps it close. Time now for an instant bargain. John has picked up a lot of instant bargains along the way. Now the question is, will he buy tonight? John, you've got a $5 lead. You can buy this.
John, life will be a little softer wearing these beautiful cashmere sweaters. Classic designs to add style and comfort to almost any wardrobe. It's yours with a gift certificate from Sale of the Century. This elegant prize is normally priced at $500. Today on Sale of the Century, it's yours for only $6.
Well, that is very nice. Mother Nature is dropping the leaves. Mother Nature looked like a stagehand, but that's a little weird. John, $500 worth of wardrobe. Now remember, a sales surprise with a bonus, of course, could come up as well. You have a $5 lead. You need a win in $95 for the cash, jackpot, plus everything else on the stage. $6, more than the value of one question.
Oh, here
one,
he goes again.
Two, three, here he goes again. Four, five, I don't know how much I got here, John. Six, I've got $600 in cash, an $1,100 bargain for $6, but you would be trailing by a dollar. Going once, going twice, no sale. John's going for some big things. Don't think a $5 lead is big enough to buy, huh? Back with us. On what daytime soap opera did he star before Rick Springfield, Chip?
General Hospital.
Before he became a rock star, General Hospital it is. Chip ties John. Physics, chemistry, peace, medicine, literature, and economics. John.
They're all Nobel Prizes.
That's what they are, and John goes back into the lead by five. This document is considered to be the highest law of the land. John.
The Constitution.
It is indeed, and two in a row for John. Stretches that lead to $10. Speaking of $10, $10 money card, one of the things up there on the board now with the fame game, we look for a famous person. Buzz in when you know. Famous person. Some people say I'm mythical, while others consider me a real person. A Frenchman named Charles Perrault published my first book in which my name was mentioned. My son-in-law is supposed to have published a book of songs and rhymes I sang to my grandchildren. There are still others who attribute these children's to John?
Mother Goose.
You are right.
For a pick of the board. They don't know whether she existed or not. John, a pick of the board.
Oh, I want that money card. Seven.
And behind number seven, we have a people.